Hello students, welcome to RD Chemistry. In this video, I will explain Lee Chatelier's principle and after that I will solve the problems. Now, what is this Lee Chatelier principle? According to Lee Chatelier principle, if a system is at equilibrium and its temperature or pressure or concentration is subjected to change. Suppose we change temperature, pressure and concentration at equilibrium, then equilibrium will shift in a direction so as to undo the effect of the change imposed. That means if I increase the pressure, equilibrium try to decrease the pressure. If we increase the temperature, equilibrium try to decrease the pressure. That is the meaning of undo the effect of the change imposed. Now see here, the point number one. Rate of the forward reaction increases when either the concentration of the reactants is increased or concentration of the product is decreased. Let me take one example. Nitrogen is a gas. Reacts with the hydrogen. 3 moles of hydrogen gas to give ammonia. Ammonia is a gas when it is a manufacturer. Okay. To balance the equation, I need to have 2 moles of the ammonia. Suppose I increase the concentration of nitrogen, I'll add more and more nitrogen at equilibrium. Then what will happen? To decrease that concentration nitrogen, forward reaction, that means more of products are formed. I can also increase the concentration of the hydrogen. If I increase the concentration of hydrogen at equilibrium position, to decrease the concentration of hydrogen, what will happen? It will favor the product formation, forward reaction. Remember? Increase the concentration of the reactant, forward reaction. Or, how to increase the forward reaction? We can also remove the ammonia as soon as formed. So, go on decreasing the concentration of the product. Remove the ammonia as soon as it is formed. Then also, it will be directed toward the forward direction. Clear? Let's see the next point. For exothermic reaction, what do you mean by exothermic reaction? In the exothermic reaction, heat is liberated during the process. For exothermic reaction, decrease in temperature favors the forward reaction. Let me take example of the nitrogen. Reacts with the hydrogen to give the ammonia NH3. Let me balance it 1 mole, here 3 mole and ammonia 2 moles. Now, during the formation of ammonia, some amount of heat is liberated. So, I'll write plus kilojoules per mole. So, that means whenever heat is liberated during the process, what will happen? Temperature increases. Okay. So, such kind of reactions are called the exothermic reaction. Suppose heat is liberated, temperature increases, then it is an exothermic reaction. So, what is about the backward reaction? Backward reaction means temperature should decrease, which means it is an endothermic reaction. Okay. So, suppose we decrease the temperature. Okay. So, temperature decreases. If I decrease the temperature, system tries to increase the temperature. So, forward reaction is favored. Remember, for exothermic reactions, where temperature increases, suppose I decrease the temperature, so system always try to increase by favoring forward reaction. Okay? So, remember, decrease in temperature, if temperature decreases, it will always favor the exothermic reaction. Similarly, if you increase the temperature, system will try to favor always the endothermic reaction. Okay, see here. Next point here. For endothermic reaction, increase in temperature favors forward reaction. Okay, clear? About the effect of the pressure now. Okay, so there are 3 cases here. When the number of moles of the reactants are equal to number of moles of the product. See here, in this example. 1 mole of hydrogen and 1 mole hydrogen. What is the total number of moles on the reactant side? 2 moles. Products, how many moles are there? 2 moles are there. Correct? Remember, pressure is directly proportional to number of moles. Correct? Clear? From the states of matter. So, if the number of moles are equal on both the sides, then pressure has no effect. Let me go for the second case. When the number of moles of the reactant greater than number of moles of the product. See here. Nitrogen 1. Hydrogen 3. So, how many moles are there? There are 4 moles of the reactants, okay? And on the products, how many moles are there? 2 moles are there, correct? Right? Now, see this statement. Forward reaction favored. It will go in the forward direction, okay? At higher temperature. Remember, number of moles are 4. And number of moles are 2 here on the product side. pressure is directly proportional number of moles. Pressure is directly number of moles. Okay. So if I want to get the forward reaction, more and more ammonia, what should I do? I should do the reverse. Okay. Increase the pressure. When increase the pressure, system tries to decrease the pressure. Decrease the pressure means it should go to that side where there are lesser number of moles. So it will go toward the ammonia. Clear? Right? Now next one. Third case. Number of moles of the reactants less than the number of moles of the product. See here, PCl5, 1 mole is there. So 1 mole of the reactant. How many moles of the products are there? 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 moles are there. Correct? Right? Suppose I want to get forward reaction. Forward reaction means pressure is more. Forward direction. Number of moles are more. So what should I do to get the forward direction? So I should go for the lower pressure, lower number of moles. If I decrease the pressure, system tries to increase the pressure by favoring the forward reaction. We can also do the reverse. Suppose I increase the pressure at equilibrium. So what will happen? It will be the backward direction. Here also same thing for the second case here. So this side it is a lesser pressure. Second example. If I lower the pressure, system tries to increase the pressure by favoring backward direction. So if I increase the pressure, system tries to decrease the pressure. Also remember, whenever number of moles are equal on both the sides, pressure has no effect. Clear? The next one about the effect of the inert gas. What are the inert gases? Inert gas like helium, neon, argon. These are known as the inert gases, but they do not react with the other chemicals or other gases easily. Now there are two conditions here. Suppose the volume of the vessel is fixed, okay, and some reaction taking place like A and gives the C, okay. Suppose you add helium into it, okay, what will happen? Helium will not react with the gases A, B and C. Suppose you add, okay, the helium into this flask at constant volume, volume should not be increased, then there is no effect of that inert gas on the equilibrium. Okay. Next one, when added at a constant pressure, suppose I have got some vessel, some reaction taking place, A plus B giving C. Okay. Assume that here number of moles on the reactant side, 2 moles are there, 1 plus 1. And product side you got 1 mole. Okay. Assuming it is a 1 mole, 1 mole and 1 mole. Okay. Now you introduce the helium gas. What will happen now? Pressure increases here. Correct? Pressure increases. Now you have to make the constant pressure. For that what should I do? You have to increase the volume. When I increase the volume, what will happen? Pressure will be reduced now. Pressure will be reduced. Okay. It come back to the original pressure. Now pressure will be reduced. Now system what will do? System will try to increase the pressure by favoring that side reaction where there are more number of moles. Remember, therefore, reaction always goes to that direction where there are more number of gaseous moles. Let me take one example. Nitrogen reacts with the 3 moles of the hydrogen to give 2 moles of the ammonia. Assume all these are gases. We have got how many moles? 4 moles of the reactant. How many moles of products are there? 2 moles are there. Suppose I carry out, okay, the experiment at constant pressure and passing the inert gas like either helium, neon, argon. So what will happen? Which side the reaction will go? Reaction will go to that direction where there are more number of mole. That means backward direction, okay, is favored. Backward reactions favor. Okay, right? Clear? Question number one. In which of the following equilibrium, the rate of the backward reaction is favored by increasing the pressure? Remember student, when you try to increase the pressure at equilibrium, system will always try to decrease the pressure by favoring that direction where there are lesser number of moles. Lesser number of moles. Okay, lesser number of moles. Now this lesser number of moles should be there on which side? Backward direction. But we want which side direction? Backward direction we require. Okay, clear? Now in the backward direction there should be lesser number of moles. See here, first equation, 4 moles are the reactant side and 2 moles are there. So lesser number of moles in the forward direction. Reaction going the forward, not the answer. Here 1 mole plus 1 mole, 2 moles. 2 moles of reactant. Product also 2 moles reactant. Pressure has no effect. Next one. Third example, reactant is 1 mole and products are equal to 2 moles. So 2 moles are there in the backward direction. So answer is option number 3. And fourth option C. Reactant molecules moles are altogether 3 moles are there and the product is 2 mole. So it will go toward the lesser number of mole. That means it goes in the backward direction. So therefore answer is option number 3. Clear? Question number 2. For the gaseous reaction, A plus B giving 2C plus D plus Q is given. Q is the heat liberated. E is most favorable at. Let me write down the reaction again. A plus B is in equilibrium with the 2C plus D. Plus we have got Q. This is nothing but the heat liberated. When heat is liberated, forward reaction is an exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction means temperature increases. Which means backward reaction is an endothermic reaction, where temperature decreases. Also, see to that number of moles on the reactant side. Assuming 1 and 1, it is 2 moles of the reactants are there. On the product side, 2 plus 1, this is 1, is equal to 3 moles are there. But I want the forward reaction to be favored. Okay, reaction favored means it should go to the forward direction. Now, what should I do with respect to temperature? See here, everywhere they are mentioned with respect to temperature and pressure. So, see here, 2 moles are there. 2 moles become 3 moles. 2 moles become 3 moles. That means number of moles has to increase. Pressure has to increase. What should I do? We have to decrease the pressure. Okay. So there should be lower pressure. Pressure should be lower. Okay. When you decrease the pressure, system tries to increase the pressure by favoring that side where there are more number of moles. Okay. Now with respect to temperature, I want forward reaction, exothermic reaction. Temperature should increase. What should I do? I should do the reverse. So we should decrease the temperature. I should decrease the temperature. System tries to increase the temperature by favoring exothermic reaction. Now exothermic reaction is the forward reaction here. Clear? So both pressure and temperature should be low. What is the answer now? Option number 3 is the answer. Clear? Question number 3. For a reaction, if Kp is greater than Kc, the forward reaction is favored by. Now we have to take a relation between Kp and Kc. Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power delta n. Suppose delta n is equal to 0, then in that case, Kp is equal to Kc. Suppose delta n is a positive number, then Kp is also greater than Kc. And suppose delta n is less than 0, negative quantity, Kp is less than Kc. So given here, reaction Kp is greater than Kc, means for this reaction, delta n is greater than 0. How do you calculate delta n? Delta n is equal to number of moles of the product minus number of moles of the reactant, only for the gases it is, correct? That means the number of moles of the product should be greater compared to number of moles of the product. Then only the value difference should be greater than 0. When I take the difference, NP minus NR should be greater than 0. Difference will be greater than 0. That means product number of moles, okay? Number of moles of the product greater compared to that of the reactant. Let me take like this. 1 mole of A reacts with the 1 mole of B to give, say, 4 moles of the C. Here there are how many moles are there? There are 2 moles altogether. Here how many moles are there? Assume there are 4 moles are there. On the product side, number of moles are more. That's why delta n is greater than 0. Okay, clear? How do you calculate delta n greater than 0? Product in moles are 4 minus reactant moles are 2. Therefore, it is equal to, which is greater than 0. Correct? Now, I want the forward direction. Forward direction means increase in the number of moles. Increase in the number of moles means more is the pressure. So what should I do? Always do the reverse. So lesser number of moles is the lower pressure. Lower pressure, lower number of moles. Higher pressure, higher number of moles. So what should I do is decrease the pressure. System tries to increase the pressure by favoring now forward reaction. What should I do with respect to pressure? I should decrease the pressure, lower the pressure so that system tries to increase. In this case, increase in pressure is the forward reaction. Clear? Question number 4. Reaction given plus heat. Heat is liberated. What is the effect of increasing pressure on the equilibrium reaction? Let me write down the same reaction. 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with the 3 moles of the hydrogen to give 2 moles of the ammonia and plus heat is liberated. Heat is liberated means temperature increases, which means it is an exothermic reaction. Forward reaction exothermic. Therefore, backward reaction be endothermic reaction where temperature should decrease. Correct? Now, what they given is increase in temperature. They try to increase the pressure. Suppose they increase the temperature. Clear? So it is on the product side increases temperature. Correct? Suppose I increase the temperature, system always try to do the reverse. That means if I increase the temperature, system will try to always decrease the temperature. That means endothermic reactions favor. Here endothermic reaction is the backward reaction. Okay, backward reaction means it is on the left hand side. Correct? So therefore, option number is 3. Equilibrium is shifted to the left hand side. Clear? Question number 5. Yield of the products in the reaction, and they are given at the end Q kilojoule, that means heat is liberated, would be higher at. Okay, now let me write the same reaction A2. Okay, 1 mole of A2 reacts to the 2 moles of the gas B to give C plus heat is liberated. Q kilojoule heat is liberated. Heat liberated means temperature increase, that means it is an exothermic reaction. Forward reaction exothermic reaction, therefore backward reaction should be endothermic reaction where temperature should decrease. Also see the number of moles on reactant side. 1 plus 2, 3 moles are there. Correct? 3 moles are there. On the product side, only 1 mole of the product is there. So 1 mole is there. Question is, product, yield of the product would be higher. That means we want forward reaction. We want forward reaction. Here, forward reactions are exothermic. Exothermic reactions favored only when you decrease the temperature. Do the opposite always. So decrease the temperature, system will try to increase the pressure, so forward reaction. So with respect to temperature, lower temperature. With respect to pressure, see here, 3 moles will become 1 mole, but still I want in the forward direction, correct? So there should be decrease the number of moles. What should I do? So that 4, therefore I have to increase the pressure. If I increase the pressure, system will try to decrease the pressure and the reaction goes to that direction where there are lesser number of moles, okay? So I should increase the pressure. Pressure should be higher. Okay. So always do the reverse. So therefore, what is the answer here? Answer is option number 3. Lower temperature and the higher pressure is the answer. Okay. Please like the videos, share the videos, and please subscribe RD Chemistry YouTube channel as well as the Telegram channel. And also write down the comments. Thank you for watching.